Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your part two of episode 928 for your glorious Lord's Day Sunday, December the 11th, 2022. And this one, we're going to be clinging to what's good from Katara Patton, K-A-T-A-R-A-P-A-T-T-O-N, Katara Patton, derived from Romans 12, 9 through 13. So if you're excited about this one, smash the like button. Smashing the like button will help the video reach other people. And remember, 4 likes only per video until further notice. Go watch the morning video for explanation. But subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Share the video channel with your family and friends. Help me reach the 30 subscriber mark by January 1st, 2023. Which is 3 weeks away. So, if we hit 30 before the 1st, then we will go to 50 by the Valentine's Day, March 1st at the latest. And then one thing I want for my birthday in April, April the 18th, is to be at 100 subscribers. So if you do that for me, I will greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate each and every one. So also, birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer requests in the comment section below. Clinging to what's good, Katara writes, when we park our car near an open field and walk across it to get to our house, we almost always get some sticky cockleburrs on our clothes. Sandsburrs. That's what they mean. Especially in the fall. These tiny hitchhikers, or it could be those little, they look like they're flat on one side and then they round on the other side. Probably those. Or some other things that they stick when you walk through the grass. They stick to your, they'll stick to your socks, they stick to your shoes, they stick to your legs, your pant legs, or whatever you got on. And then you have to sit there and pick them off to get them off. These tiny hitchhikers attach to clothing, shoes, or whatever is passing by and ride to their next destination. It's nature's way of spreading cockleburr seeds in my local field and around the world. So I'm still thinking those things that got the flat edge on one side and then it. And sometimes they come in like 3 or 4 stuck together. If you know what I'm talking about, put it in the comments. You also got those sand spurs, little spiky things that stick to everything, and if you try to pick them off with your finger, they poke you like little needles. Sorry. So, as I tried to carefully remove clinging cockleburrs, I often thought about this message that admonishes believers in Jesus to cling to what is good. Romans 12, verse 9. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. That's verse 9. So when we're trying to love others, it can be very challenging. However, as the Holy Spirit helps us hold on to what's good, with all we have, we can repel evil and be sincere in our love as He guides us. Like it says in verse 9, love must be sincere. Cockleburr seeds don't fall off with a mere brush of the hand. They hang on to you. I never understood what those called. I was always called them hitchhikers. That's all I knew growing up. Those little sticky things, they stick on you. They look like pea pods. That's what they look like. Little small pea pods. But they're flat. They hang on to you. And when we focus on what's good, keeping our mind on God's mercy, compassion, and commands, we too, in His strength, can hang on tightly to those we love. He helps us stay devoted to one another in love, remembering to place others' needs before our own. Verse 10. Yes, those cocklebirds, C-O-C-K-E-L, or K-L-E-B-U-R-S, is how that cocklebirds is spelled. But they can be very challenging. But they also remind me to cling to others in love, and by God's power to grip tightly what is good. Verse 9. Also see Philippians chapter 4, verses 8 and 9. So how can clinging to what's good help you love a challenging friend or family member? Let me know some examples or what ways you could do that by putting Q1 in the comments on that one. And how is sincere love also a tenacious love? Let me know the difference between that in the comments by putting Q2 in your response. But ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen. So make sure your subtitles are on so you can see them. And if there's some chance you don't, check the description. But say, remind me to cling with all my might to what's good, Jesus. I desire to reflect your love to others. Amen? So that should have been on the screen. If it's not, check the description. Hopefully, it'll be on there. It'll be automatic, so you don't have to worry about the subtitles. But sometimes you just go ahead and do it. But also, this will also be on screen, and it'll be in the description, this link. For further study, read What Do You Do With a Broken Relationship? Read it at discoveryseries.org/BigQ0703. So, and you know the O is always, sometimes when I read it, I read a zero as an O. So, a lot of people do, so. The Bible reading today, we're reading Hosea 5 through 8, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and then Revelation chapter 2. So, coming up tomorrow in your Fantastic Monday, episode 929, part 2, we're going to be talking about I Heard the Bells from Bill Crowder, derived from Psalm 43. So, for your Fantastic Monday, December the 12th. Part 2 of episode 929. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But you'll see that tomorrow after 1. So, with that said, I love you. Appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until tomorrow, and until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 7, and we'll be talking about part 2 of the My Favorite Things Weekend Series Turning Point for your weekend of December the 10th and 11th. And we'll be in the next Loving Your Title and Loving Your Neighbor. We was talking about loving your family last week in the first one. Now this one, we're loving your neighbors. So, beginning with Galatians 5:14, our recommended reading is Matthew 5:43-48. Our turning point is from Oswald Chambers. And like I said, your weekend reading has been Philippians and Colossians. Both books, which is both of them, are 4 chapters. So I hope you read Philippians yesterday and then read Colossians today. And they're both of them are 4 chapters. So just spread them out for the weekend. So, but with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Have a great rest of your afternoon, and I'll see you later tonight. After 7. So, with that said, or with that, me and Santa Baby Yoda, we out. Goodbye.